Hello everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank Hari and Co for inviting me over here. I have to be honest with you, I'm not too proud of this fact. I am not a bookworm. I don't read books. And I live in this silly preconceived notion that if a book is very good, it'll definitely be made into a movie. But I used to live with that notion, and actually Hari, you reinforced that with Golconda High School. So you ought to blame for, you know, for this also. Thank you. But anyway, not being a bookworm, and ironically the last book that I read also was Hari's If You Love Someone, because I was looking at ways to adapt it into a movie. There you go. Anyway. This being a non-fiction book and me not being a bookworm, I was very pleasantly surprised because it was very, very accessible to me. And generally, like self-help books, you know, they have this, you can walk into a trap by being cliche, by being preachy. And Hari has beautifully sidestepped those two problems, like, you know, by incorporating by blending it with cricket and movies. And what better way to do that, seriously? And because those two, sports and movies, are my primary interest in life. And I'm a sports junkie, sports addict, and I believe that everything you need to learn in life, that you can learn in life, you can do through sports. And this is why I really like this book. Very accessible, very easy to pick up, and the way he blended many things, many quotes, innings, like, you know, real life cricket innings, his own personal experiences, excerpts from other books, from movies. So it is very, very accessible to every person, I think, and it's a must have. And I strongly suggest everyone to, like, you know, give it a read as soon as possible. Now, getting to the book, my favorite section, content rather, is actually patience. I've been accused of being patient to a fault sometimes, so, but patience is like, it was my favorite subject in this. I'm just going to read a bit from it. Michelangelo once said that genius is eternal patience. Allow the ball to come to you. I always like that. We make, sometimes, like, being in the film industry, we make like terrible blunders. We don't get the ball from you. You know, we select like bad scripts. Sometimes and sometimes it's best, like, you know, be a little patient and let things come to you. So I'm just going to read the paragraph of this on patience. If you thought batting was about going after the ball and knocking the leather off it, think again. Much of batting is about waiting. The best batsmen allow the ball to come to them and only then play it. They do not chase the ball with preconceived notions. Allowing the ball to come to them helps them to play each ball with complete focus and control, play it in the area of strength, make fine adjustments, and get better timing. I'm going to jump to the coach's corner like this. This is what I really like on this paragraph. Allow life to come to you. If you interfere with the process of life ahead of time, you may complicate issues needlessly and your response will not be assessed. If you wait, most issues may get sorted out before they even get to you. Let the moment come to you and then engage. The right moment to engage is when you feel your preparation matches the requirement of that moment. So be patient. The no ball in this section is also what I like. Jumping ahead of yourself needlessly, panicking, feeling an urge to act without being prepared for it. So, very well written, Hari. And I particularly like this. I like the way he blended. I also believe that, like, all you need to know about life is through this film called Godfather. So he was nice enough to pick a moment from The Godfather. In a key moment in The Godfather, an impatient Sonny Corleone, favorite characters, blurts out his interest in narcotic trader Salazzo's offer in a meeting presided by the Godfather. That act of impatience encourages Salazzo to attempt to kill Don Corleone, who is opposed to his son, thereby triggering the saga of revenge that consumes many, including Sonny and Salazzo amongst others. only sign a great cricket, he would have allowed the ball to come to him. Anyway, there you go. And once again, I urge all of you to pick up this book and give it a read as soon as possible. And I'll hand it over to number 3. Thank you once again.